Coach talked to Mike on the pregame show about the importance of this game for you guys. You want to make that second Whitewater game mean something, and as competitive as your division is with Edgerton and Whitewater, you know, right in the mix there, you had to win this tonight. I guess, what were your thoughts coming into this ball game, and what was the mindset for the Trojans?
We just had to come together as a team and like really pull through this to really have a chance to beat Whitewater. And now I think we're stronger as a team. We've come more together than the game of the year. I think this Broadhead game really showed that.
Yeah, and with Andrea Olson out with the concussion, you know, we kind of speculated in the pregame show how much that would, you know, force you to score in addition, you know, maybe above your 16, 17 points per game average. You came out with 31 tonight. Are you surprised?
Yeah.
31, is that at like a career high or close or?
Close. But I think by 2 points.
By 2 points. But I mean, in this situation, this kind of ball game, going up against a very tall team and a very tall player with Carly Moens, I mean, you were putting some stuff up tonight that just showed that you really wanted.
Yeah, I wanted to put everything out there, and I knew whatever happened, I just wanted to know I gave it up my all. And I know as a team, we really gave it all our all.
And I think, you know, we had a couple stop by just to see how many points you scored, because they were pretty impressed. For those who haven't seen you play, you create very well. I mean, you know, if you've got an opportunity to put the ball up towards the rim, you're going to do it. Do you want to describe what goes through your head when you're in situations where you have a shot opportunity? Because they're not all pretty, but gosh, yeah. So many of them go in.
I just think just like playing with my sister in the backyard, just like throwing out crazy shots, I think that really helped. And then just like playing like one-on-ones. So.
Well, it worked tonight. I mean, did you feel like you were in any kind of rhythm tonight? How good did you feel out there?
I felt a little nervous, but that's normal. But and then I just wanted to give it my all. And then as a team, we really talked together to give it our all. And we promised that we'll do everything for Andrea, too, because she's out. And we didn't.
Sure. And you know, it was a typical, almost like a tournament-type game. You got the lead early. You knew Broadhead would come back. They did. They got a lead late in the third quarter. And then Carly Moens, who had put a lot of energy into getting that lead, they gave her a rest. And I think it was, I'm not sure who the two girls were, but I think it was Rachel Atkinson was one and Alicia Olson the other that scored those last points of the third quarter to give you the lead back. That was huge, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was really good. Like, I think right there we kind of like knocked them out of the game. Like, you can just see in their faces. Kind of gave up, and we kept going. We kept punching them in the face.
Sure. And you guys obviously playing with a purpose. You've got that Whitewater game coming up. They've got Whitewater next. How do you see their game with Whitewater coming up on Friday with you know, Carly Moens going up against the Whippets?
I think they're going to both challenge each other, because I know both teams are big. Both teams use the post a lot. And I know both teams are quick. And then the point guards will match up with Butchun and then Douglas tonight.
Sure. And for you guys, this puts you back in good position here, you know, staying in that race. It'll be a good bus ride home, won't it?
Yeah. I think there's a lot of songs singing.
A lot of songs singing. Well, Brianna, we'll